semi-final underway. The west end of the ground, heavily populated with Hearts supporters who've made a tremendous amount of noise in anticipation of the match. And there's a bad tackle very early on. Billy Kirkwood was the offender, the player in trouble with Brian Whittaker. Whittaker appears to recover all right, but referee Brian McGinley will have a word with the Dundee United midfield player. Referee Brian McGinley going to Mexico for the World Cup finals in June. Taking a firm grip on things at the start of the match. So Dundee United coming out with no fewer than 8 full internationals in their team. Tremendous back four international lineup with Billy Thompson, the international keeper behind them. And yet another wigging for a player this time. The midfield man for Hearts, Kenny Black, is being ticked off by the referee. Well, busy start indeed for referee McGinley. There's Kenny Black. He was the man who committed that bad foul to make it one apiece in terms of bad infringements. Very calm figure in the heart of that United defence, David Neary. Dodge with a head flick. And Jordan with some time. Dodge screening it well. This is Goff. Now Sturrock. Looking for Redford. Levine wins it. There's Bannon. Well, Eamon Bannon had no hesitation at all when that ball fell to him. So United doing some useful work on the right with Paul Sturrock into the room for himself to send the ball across towards Ian Redford. Came off the head of punt there, Craig Levine. And there was Bannon with a first time hook shot on the turn. Bannon. Dodds holding off Levine. Sharp made to hurry by Sturrock. Whittaker returns it to Smith with a little word indicating that he wasn't in a very open position to receive the ball in the first place. Towards Sturrock. Levine's pass back is short, and that's good goalkeeping from Henry Smith. Well, Levine used his pace to great effect initially to get across in front of Paul Sturrock. He appeared to have things under control. The pass back was slack, and that took some good goalkeeping from Henry Smith to keep out Paul Sturrock. Nice to Cahoon. Kenny Black on the left touchline. Sandy Clark waits in the middle. Off blocks the cross. Here's Cahoon. Looking for Sandy Clark. Billy Thompson commits himself. And Bannon back helping at the edge of the box. Now Redford. United pulled back everyone except Paul Sturrock for that Hearts attack. Jordan to Levine. Again looking for Clark. There's John Cahoon. 15 minutes gone, Hearts go in front, and what a marvellous volley. Well, the danger of Sandy Clark, clear again for all to see. As Levine hoisted the ball in, Hegarty went up under pressure from Clark, couldn't get a part of him headed on it, fell to the right foot of John Cahoon, and Billy Thompson had to get out there. So John Cahoon picks up his 9th goal of the season, and the Hearts end to a left, go crazy. Now Kenny Black. Jordan. Levine easing himself away from Dodds. The layoff from Cahoon is accurate. There's Sandy Clark. And a tie to Cahoon. Kid linking up on the right. Invited to chase by Guy. Corner kick off Eamon Bannon. Good creative play on the right from Hearts. And the captain, Walter Kidd, picking up to good effect. So Kenny Black will take the in-swinger for Hearts. had almost lost out to Levine. A little bit of uncertainty there in the Dundee United defence. Still, they're in trouble as Cahoon flies forward and breaks back to Mackay. And very close again. Cahoon appeals to the corner and gets it. Cahoon and Robertson on the end of the cross. And Billy Thompson at full stretch to see the ball go wide, but it's still Hearts on the ascendancy. And with that opening goal behind them, pressing for a second, which would surely make the United task well nigh impossible. Given away by Holt. Kidd. 1-2 with Whittaker, a great chance for Hearts. Queued up in the middle, but no one could get it. Cahoon was there, Robertson was there, Sandy Clark. Well, what a wonderful 1-2 it was at the edge of the box. Kidd to Whittaker, return pass, split the United defence, and Walter Kidd had a great chance to make it 2-0 to Hearts. Clark just through the middle. Whittaker's clearance. Holding off Hegarty. Redford forcing it forward. Now Byron has a chance to take on Kidd on the left. With very few chances to run at the Hearts right back. David Dodds in the layoff. There's Kirkwood. Now Holt. David Dodds. Diving header got again, and Richard Goff was on the end of that. Frustration for the international defender joining the United attack again. His diving header deflected wide to the corner kick. Oh, Eamon Bannon. Early on the pressure for United. Berry won it. Berry again. Kirkwood. It was Goff who was offside. It was Paul Sturrock through the middle. Out by John Holt from Kenny Black, and Hearts again with the draw. This is a vital phase in the match. Closing minutes of the first half. A goal at either end would have a tremendous impact on the proceedings, I would suggest. Robertson's in the clear. Chance now for Hearts. It's queuing up in the middle. And Thompson settles it with some superb goalkeeping. Was a great chance for Hearts as Robertson broke to the far side, lots of space, support arriving in the middle, literally John Cahoon, cross driven across, and there was Billy Thompson. There goes the half-time whistle, not too many of the finer points on display in that 45 minute period, but an immensely competitive cup tie with Hearts having the edge, and the goal coming in the 13th minute. Ball was pumped in by Craig Levine. Clark challenged Hegarty into that weak header. Cahoon with the instant volley. That's what gives Hearts a lead, which on the first half play they certainly deserve. Hearts 1, Dundee United 0. Join us right after the break. Dundee United manager Jim McLean has acknowledged the need for change in the United lineup for the second half. And there's a substitution. Here's Kevin Gallagher, wearing number 14, who has replaced Billy Kirkwood in the United midfield. Sturrock's header, a chance now for Redford. Sturrock and Dodds are in the middle. Good effort from Redford, and that's a corner kick. Henry Smith claiming that the ball was behind before he handled it. Great effort that from Redford. Parried by Smith. Starts. Kick. Good punch out from Smith. Holt returns it. Goes off. Dodds pops it back out towards Starrock. Taking on Jordan. Oh, yeah, very well indeed, Paul Starrock, to engineer the shooting chance. Finish was well off top. Well, the ball seems to bobble as he went to strike it. Cahoon and Hegarty steps in for United, tried to find Gallagher with the pass. Kidd, Mackay, that's for Black, a chance for Hearts. Superb piece of play from Hearts. The United defence was carved wide open. Kenny Black's finish wasn't good enough. Well set up. Black made an early run. He wasn't used the first time by Gary Mackay. But then when the pass came through, he came across the United defence and the shot knocked it too high. Dodge to Goff. A loose pass though, intercepted by Whittaker, and United are exposed at the back for a moment. Tested down by Robertson. Here's Cahoon. Now Sandy Clark. Getting to close quarters with him. He's giving that away. Up to Berry. There's Robertson trying to turn. Chance is on for Black. He was trying to tee it up for Gary Mackay in the end. No offside flag. There's Robertson. Berry getting to close quarters too, and it's behind. Goal kick is given. Angry about that, and United at the same time wonder why they didn't get an offside decision. No halt. Gallagher taking it in a very tight position. Good cross control. For the byline. Jordan turned it out for the throw. Gallagher trying to make headway on the right flank for United. O'Bannon. Holt. That's a corner kick. For United, push the big men forward again. Only Cahoon and Robertson out of that Hearts box for a moment among the Hearts players. It didn't fall kindly for Dodds. A glancing header initially from Richard Goff. Sturrock. Now pass. Finds its way to Dodds. Now Holt. Bannon called for it on that left touchline. Taking on Berry. That's a good cross. Queuing up there, and it's beaten out by Henry Smith in the end. Well, what a great chance that was for Dundee United. Was it Richard Goff with the header? Well, it was down to the ability of Eamon Bannon. With that outswinging cross, the challenge coming in. Indeed, it was Redford with the header. And a let off for Hearts. Down goes Goff, appeals for a penalty kick, waved aside by the referee, and that has incensed the United players and the United bench. Now they're on the defence with John Cahoon. Billy Thompson handled the ball, a free kick's been given. But bedlam around Hampden. Ryan McGinley, I'm sure, will put the United goalkeeper. He came out of his box. But was that a penalty kick for Dundee United? Richard Goff, trying very hard to control the ball, appeared to be taken to the back, and on this angle, that certainly looked to be a good United claim. Oh, Kenny Black with a free kick. Yeah, he got his head to the ball, and it's away unceremoniously by Ian Redford. Well, both these sides operating to the very limits of their strength, skill and endurance. What a struggle it is. And a chance now for Cahoon. No one waiting in the middle except Malpass for United. Now Dodds. Bannon. A neat sidestep. Richard Goff powering his way up the right, and that's well read by Whittaker. Now goes Cahoon, and Hegarty this time will be in trouble. United captain, the latest player in the saga to be shown the yellow card. And John Cahoon taking a full brunt. Yet another hefty tackle from Dundee United. A torrid cup semi-final indeed. 20 minutes left. Hearts still leading by John Cahoon's early goal. Whittaker's free kick. Goff's header. Well guarded by Gallagher. Dodds with a head flick. Stullock helps it into the path of Redford. Bannon supporting. Richard Goff heading it into the path of Gallagher. A chance on now for United. Paul Stullock! Brilliant goalkeeper. Well, United now throwing in all the reserves. Tremendous play. Played wide to Gallagher by Goff. He is afflicted by Stark. He can't believe the save from Henry Shearer. This Holtz now in the right back position. Goes off. Gallagher getting a touch. Going into the box. Still Kevin Gallagher. Everything except the finish was right for Gallagher. Shake of the head. 19-year-old Kevin Gallagher. Definitely showed all his determination, forcing his way through that tackle, finding it into a shooting position, and the ball screws wide. You can hear the build-up of noise from the Hearts end. They haven't been in the cup final for 10 years. Handball by Redford. That surely will give Hearts the time to keep the ball in the United half until the final whistle. Changes to